In today's video, I want to show you how you can use GDrive, which is a part of Google Workspace, to increase your productivity and make your workflow a whole lot easier. Personally, I absolutely love GDrive and I wouldn't know how to function my whole workflow without it. There's so many features that save time and make working so much easier, and you're going to see that later on. Now, Google Drive is a file storage system in the cloud, so on Google servers, something similar to Dropbox if you've used that before. So you get all the benefits of cloud storage, which means if you're like me and you're not so great at backing up your laptop or your computer all the time, it is really good because you're not going to lose your files if your laptop would ever break or something happened to it. Another benefit of having your files online means that you can easily share them with other people, collaborate and work together on certain files and folders. You can access them from everywhere, so from your desktop, from anywhere, any computer that has internet. You can even download the GDrive app on your phone if you want to quickly look up some documents or share them with another person. One of the most helpful things that I use all the time is that you can get a little link to a certain document that you can then put into, for example, your Asana or whatever project management system you use, especially if you have reoccurring tasks that you do every day, for example, or your tracking sheet or whatever. You can just put that link into the task, and that means you don't have to search through your folders to get that specific document because you already have the direct link to that. So if you want to save time and use all these amazing features of GDrive or Google Drive in Google Workspace, then keep on watching.
So if you have a private Gmail account, you might have used Google Drive or GDrive before, as usually with that, you get like 15 gigabytes of space for Google Drive. However, if you want to use it for a business, that's probably not going to get you very far. And also the business version obviously comes with all these other features. So let's have a quick look what you can get here with Google Workspace. GDrive, so just if you look at the storage here, so with the business starter, the smallest package you get already 30 gigabytes, and then it goes up pretty quickly to 2 terabytes or 5 terabytes or however much you need. And even if you sign up to this one, you can always get more storage if you need. And also with the Google Workspace, you get all of these other things as well. So you get your secure business email. If you want to know more about that one, check out the video I'm going to link in here and in the description of how to set that up. I've got a whole tutorial video on that, which is, in my opinion, it is the best business email setup. And it comes included in Google Workspace as well as all these other things. So you might have used Google Docs before, Google Sheets, which is kind of similar to Microsoft Word and Excel, and slides as PowerPoint. And then you also get your calendar, chat, Google Meet, which is a video conferencing software. You get all of that included. So it is well worth it, even past the Drive, which is already so amazing, as you will see. So these are your pricing options. You can you get a free trial for 14 days, first of all, to try it all out. And then you can choose from these options here. But as I said, most of the time, you can start with the smallest package here, and then you can upgrade whenever you need to. So here we are in my Google Drive. As you can see here, I've used 10 gigabytes out of my 30, but I can always click on buy storage and get some more, which is going to give you some options here as to, you know, I could easily buy another 100 gigabytes for only $2.50 a month. So one thing to note is that the storage is actually shared across your Google Drive, your Gmail and Google Photos, which is not something that I use. However, Gmail, so if you get large attachments in your Gmail, that might be worth looking at if you run out of storage, and also obviously in your Google Drive. So one of the huge advantages of using Google Drive, like there's so many really, but this is one of them, is that it is just really smart. So they use some sort of a artificial intelligence that kind of tries to predict what are your most important documents, what you use, how you work, to make it easier for you to find things. So maybe, as you might know, when you get in your car and your phone kind of tells you, oh, do you want to go to this place, because that's where you go every day at that time. It is a bit spooky, but at the same time, it is really handy. So that's kind of what happens here as well. it'll suggest to you the files that you've been using or what it thinks that you might need. So these are my folders that I currently have set up in this drive. I like to set it up somewhat like the departments that you would have in your business, or the kind of different areas that you would be working in. So I have usually some sort of an admin folder where I've got all the admin things that you that kind of come with running a business. Then I've got a marketing folder, products and services, and then vision and planning, and a bit of like studying or what I'm currently looking at. And the nice thing is that you can color code these things. If you right click on a folder, you can just change the color to whatever you like. Makes it a bit easier to find what you need. And this is just the general folder structure, right? And then here on the left, you can also see this kind of unfolded. So I have subfolders underneath. So you've got all your documents and files in your folders. You can actually upload any sort of file. You can upload videos and images. So you have a couple of options to make life easier to find things. So you have recent files here. So that'll show you whatever you've been using and working on last. You also have start here. So you can add a start to certain documents that you use all the time, for example. But a really great thing is this priority box here as well, which is what I spoke about earlier, the AI, where they're kind of predicting what you might need. But also what you can do here is create yourself some workspaces. So essentially what a workspace is just a view that you create of documents. So you don't move documents, they stay in the folders that you put them in. However, you can create a workspace. So say at certain times you need to do certain tasks, so say text time. So you can create a new workspace here, call it, for example, text time, which I have here already, and then you can add files to that. So let's say in text time you need your 2022 sales plan or whatever you had there. You might add like another list of your expenses or your numbers planner or whatever, and you can add all of these in there. So you don't need to go through your folders, you have everything in your workspace. So when you view the workspace, you've got everything here ready to go, what you need to complete this task. Or another example would be maybe content creation. So I've created this one here where let's say today is my day to create content. So I'm going to need my 2022 goals plan or whatever my plan is for the year, because that's how I'm going to create my content. And then I want to make YouTube videos, so I need my script template so that I can create some scripts. And, you know, you can add whatever else you might need. So you've got everything in one place and you don't need to go through different folders and find all the things. And another thing that is really great in Google Drive is the search. So it is actually really advanced and it searches through folders, documents, even images and PDFs. So you can see here, I've got this PNG image in here and, you know, it says more freedom in here. So let's just keep that in mind. And I'm just going to go to my drive. So we can't see this in here, but I want to find this image. So I'm just going to type in more freedom. And this image, which has nothing about freedom in the title or anything, it comes up because it's in the picture. So this is amazing for, you know, trying to find something. If you have a lot of folders and you can't remember where you put something, this is such a good way to find things. And you also have some filters in here where you can, you know, maybe find something based on the type, the owner. As I said, you can upload any sort of files that you might have on your computer. You can also use these Google Docs sheets and slides and forms and so on that come with Google Workspace, obviously. So say you wanted to create a new Google document, you can either create a blank document or there's a whole bunch of templates that come with this. You can just grab one of these many templates if you have to write a letter or a report or whatever it may be. So let's just take this as an example here. And it's just going to create this document. What you can then do, move it to wherever you want it. So it'll just put it in your drive into the kind of main folder, and then let's say we want to move it into admin, so we'll just choose that. And then when you go back into your admin folder, into my admin folder, as you will see here, I might just upload something just so that you can see this. So I've got this PDF here, and you can drag and drop things into here, or you can upload them through here, file upload, folder upload. Also, you can create a folder through here. And as you can see now, this PDF, it says the file size is 35 kilobyte, and that's how much storage it's using. However, this letter, which is a Google Doc document or file, it doesn't have any, it doesn't take up any space. So what Google does is they basically give you that space for free. So all of their, if you create documents with their Google tools, it won't take up any space from your storage. So that is really, nice. And a really good thing to keep in mind. So another little thing that is really helpful, you can create a new document by just clicking on new document and then blank document here, as I showed you before. However, what you can also do is just go in here and type in doc new. And it's going to open up a new document. Same works for sheet new. And obviously it works with slide new, dot new as well. So as we talked about, all of this is obviously in the internet, in the cloud, or on Google servers. So you can access this through your web browser. You can also get it downloaded onto your computer and synced, or you can download an app on your phone if you want to quickly look up a document that you have in your Google Drive. You can do that on your phone. But also, let's say you don't have internet and you want to keep working, or you don't want to use the internet the whole time, you can actually change this to offline access as well. So if you go to settings up here, you can go to offline and tick this little box here, which is going to make the files available on your computer while you are not connected to the internet. Another great thing about Google Drive, as it is in the cloud and on the internet, is obviously the collaboration sharing tools that enable you to work easily with other people. So your team members, your contractors, or whoever else you work with. So if anybody shares anything with you, the files are going to appear here. However, you can also, you also have some options to share folders and files with other people. So for example, if we go to marketing here, content creation, let's say you've got a YouTube editor or somebody helping you with your social content. For example, I have shared this whole YouTube folder here with somebody else. So you just right click on it, you go to share, and then you can either add people in here, like I've done actually myself, and you can give them certain rights. So either they can just view, comment, or they can actually edit. They can actually edit the whole folder. You can also give temporary access or transfer the ownership, or you can remove that person again. But let's say I want to share this template with somebody. I could just go either get link or go to share and then get link from here. Copy the link and you can share. You can change the options here, what they can actually do. So they can just view it, which also means they can download it. They can comment on it, or they can actually edit it. If it is just with certain team members and contractors, I would prefer this option because you can actually see who you've shared it with, and you can remove people once they don't need the access anymore. If you use the link option, you don't know who has the link and who can access it. So if you ever wanted to change it, it's just harder to do that. However, let's say you want to share this to a bigger group on the internet for like a freebie or something to download, you probably have to use this option because obviously you don't know the people who are going to be accessing the link. However, the way I use this link feature a lot is basically just, if I have this YouTube script template here, I'm just going to get the link, and then I have a certain Asana task where I, you know, which is, you know, maybe in my schedule for tomorrow, I have to create YouTube scripts. I would just drop this link in there so that I don't have to search for it. I don't even have to go into my Google Drive. I just straight from Asana, click on the link and I'm where I need to be. So literally my whole Asana is full of links to my G Drive, which makes things so much easier because you know, I just look into my Asana in the morning and this is what I have to do. And all of my tasks have a link to the documents that I need to work on. Especially if you have reoccurring tasks that you're doing, that really, really speeds up the process. So I can only recommend to do that. And obviously, if you have the files on your computer, you can't just grab a link and put that in Asana. So that's why, again, makes G Drive so, so great to work with.
So let me know in the comments if you've been using Google Drive already. What is your favorite feature of it? Or have you learned something new that you're going to use now and that's going to increase your productivity? I really want to know. Just leave me a comment. If you want to know more about Google Workspace in general and all the other apps and tools that are included, check out this video here. Also, feel free to check out this playlist where I've collected all of the videos about business setup and other tools that you might find interesting. Now have an amazing day and I'll see you in the next video.